Good morning everyone. In the last video lecture on the chapter structure of atoms and nuclei. Okay, so in this lecture we are going to study the last article from the chapter, which is nothing but the nuclear energy. And along with this article we will solve the unsolved numericals from your exercises. Okay, the article is not important from examination's point of view, because in this article we are going to consider the two reactions, nuclear reactions, which are nuclear fission and nuclear fusion. Okay, both the articles are there in your chemistry syllabus, and might be you have already studied these two kinds of the reactions, okay, which are nothing but the nuclear reactions, types of the nuclear reactions, nuclear fission process and the nuclear fusion process. Okay, actually we were using the conventional sources of energy, like the fossil fuels. And the fossil fuels includes the the petroleum, coal. Okay, all are nothing but these are the conventional sources of energy. But we all know that हे जे conventional sources of energies आहेत हे आता संपण्याच्या मार्गावर आहेत. Okay, they have the limited stores. Okay, of these kinds of the energies, conventional sources of energy. त्याच्यानंतर डिफरंट वेज फाइंड आउट करण्यात आले, ऑल्टरनेटिव मेथड्स. ओके, फॉर द एनर्जी प्रोडक्शन, ज्याच्यामध्ये सगळ्यात इम्पॉर्टंट मीन्स हायड्रो इलेक्ट्रिक पॉवर प्लांट्स. ओके, देन विंड एनर्जी. ओके, एटसेट्रा. सो हे अल्टरनेटिव मेथड सुद्धा एनर्जी प्रोडक्शनसाठी यूज केले जातात. ओके, सो जी आपण कन्व्हेन्शनल सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी मिळवतो त्यासाठी आपण केमिकल रिएक्शन्स यूज करायचो. ओके, आता इथे जी न्यूक्लिअर एनर्जी मिळणार आहे, न्यूक्लिअर एनर्जी इज नथिंग बट द नॉन कन्व्हेन्शनल एनर्जी ऑर द नॉन कन्व्हेन्शनल सोर्स ऑफ द एनर्जी. ओके, न्यूक्लिअर एनर्जी इज द एनर्जी विच इज रिलीज्ड व्हेन न्यूक्लिया अंडरगो द न्यूक्लिअर रिएक्शन्स. म्हणजे आपल्याला जी केमिकल एनर्जी फॉसिल फ्युएल थ्रू जी केमिकल एनर्जी मिळत होती ती केमिकल रिएक्शन्स मुळे मिळायची, आणि ही जी न्यूक्लिअर एनर्जी आहे ती आपल्याला कोणा थ्रू मिळते, न्यूक्लिअर रिएक्शन्स, मीन्स सच अ काइंड ऑफ रिएक्शन्स. ओके, बट न्यूक्लिअर एनर्जी प्रोडक्शन इज अ व्हेरी टाइम कंझ्युमिंग अँड अ कॉस्टली प्रोसेस. ओके, बट याच्यामध्ये जी एनर्जी मिळते, न्यूक्लिअर रिएक्शन्स मध्ये ज्या न्यूक्लिअर एनर्जी मिळतात त्या इन टर्म्स ऑफ मेगा इलेक्ट्रॉन व्होल्ट असतात. इतकी हाय एनर्जी आपल्याला न्यूक्लिअर रिएक्शन्स मध्ये मिळते. जर तेच आपण केमिकल रिएक्शन्स कन्सिडर केले तर तेवढ्याच अमाऊंटच्या फ्युएलसाठी आपल्याला एनर्जी ह्या इलेक्ट्रॉन व्होल्टच्या टर्म मध्ये मिळतात. मीन्स न्यूक्लिअर रिएक्शन्स मध्ये लार्ज अमाऊंट ऑफ एनर्जी आपण काय करू शकतो, मिळवू शकतो विथ द हेल्प ऑफ द सेम क्वांटिटी ऑफ द फ्युएल. ओके, सो व्हेन वन न्यूक्लियस or a pair of nuclei due to their interaction undergo a change in their structure resulting in the new nuclei. Okay, and generating the energy in this process. Means nuclear fission madhe highly unstable nuclei, okay, or the heavy nuclei splits into the two lighter nuclei. Okay, so in this process the large amount of energy in terms of mega electron volt is released. Okay, and that is nothing but the nuclear energy. Apan processes lit hoto bagha decay madhe, alpha decay, beta decay, gamma decay, I hope tumcha lakshat asel. To kya processes madhe apan vegvegya reactions lilelya hotya. For example, mi ek the reaction mention karte, uranium 90 236. So this is the highly unstable nuclei. Okay, So it spontaneously emits the radiations barium and krypton. Okay, for example, so its atomic number is 56, mass number is 40, krypton have atomic number 36 and mass number 94. So here 2N01 plus Q. This Q is nothing but the energy released in this process. And this kind of reaction or the process is called as nuclear fission. So in case of nuclear fission, a heavy nucleus, this is the heavy nucleus, this heavier nucleus splits into the two lighter nuclei after bombardment with the release of energy is called as the nuclear fission process. So these are nothing but the two lighter nuclei, okay, and these two nuclei are called as daughter nuclei and this is called as the parent nuclei. So in this process the energy is released. This energy generated, ka hi energy generate hote due to the concept of mass defect. Upon already mass defect chi concept pahileli ahe. So kya mass defect ya concept mule hi energy ji ahe ti actually generate hote. And what is mean by this mass defect? Mass defect is defined as the mass of parent nuclei, means this nuclei, minus the mass of the daughter nuclei. So we can write mass of the parent nuclei minus the mass of the product. Yaat nucleus pasun he don nuclei tayar zhalele ahe pan tense masses same nastat. So this difference in masses of the parent nuclei minus the product nuclei, that is called as the mass defect. Note that this nuclear energy generation is very complex and expensive process. It can also be extremely harmful, okay, and hence requires extreme cautions while generating the nuclear energy, okay. Ya type cha reactions kiwa ya nuclear fission ani nuclear fission ya reactions hota na aplyala prachanda kaalji ghyavi lagte कारण ह्या खूप हार्मफुल रिएक्शन्स आहेत, डेंजरस रिएक्शन्स आहेत, ओके. सो हियर द एनर्जी विच इज प्रोड्यूस्ड इन दिस फिशन प्रोसेस इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट्स, ओके. दैट इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ हीट विच कैन बी कलेक्टेड एंड कन्वर्टेड टू द अदर फॉर्म्स ऑफ द एनर्जी एज नीडेड, ओके. सो दिस इज नथिंग बट द न्यूक्लियर fission reaction, okay. Now there is a small article in your chapter which is called as nuclear reactor. Maybe tya term chi definition vagere fakta vicharli jail, otherwise baki kai tyacha madhe vicharnyasarkha nahi. So nuclear reactor is an apparatus or a device in which nuclear fission is carried out, okay, in a controlled manner and to produce energy in the form of heat which is then converted to the electricity. As I have already told you that these kinds of reactions are so harmful and dangerous, so all these reactions are performed in a controlled manner. So the device or apparatus which is used for this purpose, it is called as nuclear reactor, okay. Now there is again another term in your chapter which is given called as the chain reaction, okay. So chemistry madhe tumhi ti chain reaction sudha study keleli ahe, so mi tyacha baddal hi farse kai sangat basnar nahi. So the successive fissions due to a large number of neutrons released during the process, okay, give the tremendous increase in magnitude of the energy released in the reactions, and this process is called as the chain reaction. Example sathi tani uranium 92-236 example dilela ahe, tumhi te pahu shakta, but te examination madhe kutehi vicharla janar nahi, okay. So दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द कन्सेप्ट ऑफ न्यूक्लियर फिशन. तो तुम्हाला एग्जाम मध्ये विचारलं जाईल व्हाट इज द न्यूक्लियर फिशन रिएक्शन अँड राईट इट्स वन ऑफ द एक्झाम्पल्स. सो न्यूक्लियर फिशन मीन्स द प्रोसेस इन विच ए हेवियर न्यूक्लिया स्प्लिट्स इन टू द टू लाइटर न्यूक्लियास ओके अँड द लार्ज अमाऊंट ऑफ एनर्जी इज जनरेटेड इन दिस प्रोसेस. सो दिस इज द न्यूक्लियर फिशन रिएक्शन ओके. So this nuclear fission reaction may takes place at the ordinary temperature. The sources of the fissionable materials, fissionable means jay fission hou shakta, jay split hou shakta, fissionable materials is limited. The products of nuclear fission are in general radioactive and pose a radiation hazard, means a dangerous effect. Okay, so he zhala sagra nuclear fission baddal. Now the second process is the nuclear fusion. So the nuclear fusion reaction means the process in which two lighter nuclei combine together to form a heavy nucleus. दोन lighter nuclei पासून आपल्याला काय मिळवायचं आहे heavy nucleus means fuse करायचे तो दोन nuclei आणि कुठलं reaction आहे ते nuclear fusion. A very high temperature of the order of million of degrees is required for the nuclear fusion reaction. Nuclear fission sa nahi aahe, nuclear fission takes place at the ordinary temperature as well. So nuclear fusion honyasathi aplyala millions of degree temperature required aahe. The sources of this kinds of reaction, fusion reaction, that is hydrogen is more plentiful. Okay. And then the products of the fusion are non-radioactive and pose no radiation hazard. Means yacha peksha hi reaction jast hazardous ahe. Okay. So ya don kaincha reactions fakt explain karaycha hotya. Majha according hi article kai vicharla janar nahi. But jari aalo tari fakt definitions asnare tyacha ani ek ek example tumhala sangayla allowed. Okay. So now we are moving towards the unsolved problems from the chapter. Actually right now I don't have your textbook, Maharashtra syllabus textbook, so I brought reference books to solve the numericals. It's easy to tell you the final answer because we don't have that much time to solve the example step by step. So please use the log table टू सिम्प्लिफाय दी स्टेप्स. लॉग टेबल तुम्ही जर जास्त दिवस नाही वापरलं तर मे बी तुम्ही ते काही त्याच्या स्टेप्स विसरूही शकता. सो एक्झाम्पल सॉल्व्ह करण्यासाठी प्लीज लॉगबुकचा यूज नक्की करा. ओके सो मी सिक्वेन्समध्ये येणार नाही बट आपण काही एक्झाम्पल्स या टॉपिकमधले घेऊयात. ओके सो फर्स्ट डिटरमाइन द सेरीज लिमिट ऑफ बाल्मर पॅशन and Pfund series. Given the limit for Lyman series is 912 angstrom. So apnala kadhayla kay sangitle bagha, Balmer series, Pfund series and Pfund series. Okay, and given series limit for Lyman series. Okay, and what is the series limit for the Lyman series? The given value is 912 angstrom. This is the given value. Okay, so have to solve this numerical. So use the Bohr's empirical formula. According to the Bohr's empirical formula, 1 upon lambda is equal to R into 1 upon P square minus 1 upon N square. Here P is nothing but the inner energy level and N is nothing but the outer energy level. Okay. So for the series limit, मी आधी सांगितलंय series limit means shortest wavelength. Hydrogen spectrum मध्ये जेव्हा आपण series बघितल्या, spectral series in case of hydrogen spectrum, or the energy level diagram for the hydrogen spectrum. त्या आपल्या व्हिडिओ मध्ये मी एक्सप्लेन केलेलं होतं. Whenever there is a word series limit or the shortest wavelength in a particular series, substitute n is equal to infinity. So त्या वेळेला n ची व्हॅल्यू किती ठेवायची directly? Infinity. Okay? So 1 upon infinity means 0. So we can write 1 upon lambda is equal to r by p square. Or we can write lambda is equal to p square by r. Straightforward. Okay? And p is nothing but the inner energy level. Okay? So for the first series, means for Lyman series. Okay? So for Lyman series, we can write for Lyman series 1 by lambda. Lyman series means p is equal to 1. Okay? So p is equal to 1 means 1 square by r. Okay? So 1 by r, which is equal to the given value, that is nothing but the 912 angstrom, the series limit for the this value. Okay? Now for Balmer series. Okay? For Balmer series. For Balmer series. Lambda. Lambda V is nothing but the Balmer series. So for Balmer series, P is equal to. So for Balmer series, the value of P is 2. Substitute here P as 2. 2 square divided by R. So it is equal to 4 by R. And we know that 1 by R is nothing but the given value 912. So 4 into 912, it is equal to 3648 angstrom. Okay. So this is the shortest wavelength in case of the Balmer series. Means the series limit for the Balmer series. Okay. The third is nothing but the passion. So Lyman Balmer passion. So for passion series, P is equal to 3. So it's 3 square by R. So 9 into 1 by R. So 9 into 912, which is equal to, its value is 8208 angstrom. Okay. And the third, P fun series. So sequence is Lyman Balmer passion brackets P fun. Okay. So P fun is the fifth series in the sequence. So for P fun series, for P fun series, this value of P is 5. So 5 square upon R. So 25 into 912. And its answer is, just multiply this, you will get the answer as 22800 angstrom. Okay. So these are the values for shortest wavelength series limit for Lyman series, Balmer series, then Passion series and Pfeffer series. Okay. Now the next example. Ya kinds of examples hai barach vela vicharle jate. Okay. Now we are moving towards the next type of the next example, and the example is an electron. Maja example to sequence yenar nahi, tumhi textbook madhe he examples shodha. Okay. An electron in hydrogen atom stays in its second orbit for 10 raised to minus 8 seconds. So electron is given in hydrogen atom and it stays in its second orbit. Okay, in second orbit, and the time is given, the time is equal to 10 raised to minus 8 seconds. How many revolutions will it make around the nucleus in that time? Okay, so we can write here. The electron in the second orbit will transit to the first orbit, and energy difference between the two levels, according to the Bohr's postulates, we can write the change in energy, okay, while transmission of electron from the higher energy level to the lower energy level is delta E is equal to H times nu. This delta E is nothing but the En minus Ep. I hope तुमच्या हे सगळं लक्षात आहे. It is equal to H nu. This is the higher energy level and this is the lower energy level. Okay? So En minus Ep. So we can write this nu as En minus Ep divided by H. So find the value of En and find the value of Ep. So electron हा कुठल्या orbit मध्ये आहे? Second orbit मध्ये आहे. So higher energy level means En. आणि तो कुठे transit करणार? Second energy level to first energy level. Right? So P is equal to 1. So in this example, N is equal to 2 and P is equal to 1. इलेक्ट्रॉन हा आता सेकंड एनर्जी लेवल मध्ये आहे आणि तो जंप कुठे करणार आहे फर्स्ट एनर्जी लेवल मध्ये. सो एन इक्वल्स टू 2 एंड पी इज इक्वल टू 1. सो ई एन मायनस ई पी डिवाइडेड बाय एच. राइट? सो वी कैन राइट दिस न्यू एज व्हाट इज द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर एन. ई एन, ई एन इज इक्वल टू माइनस 13.6 डिवाइडेड बाय एन स्क्वेअर. So here minus 13.6 divided by 4. So minus 13.6 divided by 2 square. Minus of minus 13.6 divided by 1 square. Into 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 in terms of joule. These values are in terms of the electron volt. So convert the value in terms of joules. 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. Okay. This is the minus 19. Okay. Whole divided by H. And what is the value of H? It's 6.63 into 10 raised to minus 34. This is the value of Planck constant. Okay. So simplify it. You will get the answer for nu as nu is equal to 2.46 into 10 raised to 15 hertz. आपण इथे फक्त बोर्स पॉस्टुलेट वापरलेला आहे. En minus Ep is equal to H nu. ओके? आणि त्याच्यावरून आपण कोणाची व्हॅल्यू फाइंड आउट केलेली आहे? Nu ची, की जी आहे 2.46 into 10 raised to minus, sorry, into 10 raised to 15. ओके? Now, thus in 1 second, okay, electron completes these much of revolutions in 1 second. So ह्या एका सेकंड मधले हे रिव्हॉल्यूशन्स आहेत. सो इन 10 रेज टू मायनस 8 सेकंड द नंबर ऑफ रिव्हॉल्यूशन्स परफॉर्म बाय द इलेक्ट्रॉन. सो जस्ट मल्टीप्लाय 2.46 इंटू 10 रेज टू 15 बाय 10 रेज टू मायनस 8 अँड द आन्सर टोटल नंबर ऑफ रिव्हॉल्यूशन्स मेड बाय द इलेक्ट्रॉन इट इज इक्वल टू 2.46 इंटू 10 रेज टू 7. एवढे रिव्हॉल्यूशन्स इलेक्ट्रॉन हा सेकंड सेलमध्ये करणार आहे इन टाइम 10 रेज टू मायनस 8 सेकंड. ओके? नाव द नेक्स्ट एक्झाम्पल डिटरमाइन determine the binding energy per nucleon. Binding energy per nucleon means A. Binding energy per nucleon of the americium isotope. Okay, AM 95244. Okay, given the mass to be 244.0628 U. Mass is given in terms of atomic mass unit, unified atomic mass unit. Okay. So to solve this example, so we have to find binding energy per unit nucleon. Okay. So mass is given. Okay. And that mass is equal to 244.06428 U. This is the mass of Am, americium. Okay, then mass number or the number of nucleons in it, it's 244. Okay, this is the mass number or the number of nucleons, okay, which is represented by symbol A. Then the number of protons here, 95. Number of neutrons, 244 minus 95, which are equal to 149. And our aim is to find binding energy per unit nucleon. So first of all, find binding energy and then divide it by 244. Okay. So to find binding energy, use the Einstein's mass energy relation, which is nothing but delta m into c square. Okay. So this delta m is nothing but the, what is the formula for this delta m? It's z times mp, z is the atomic number, mass of each proton, okay, plus number of neutrons, mass of each neutron, minus m. So this is nothing but the delta m, mass defect, and into c square, velocity of the light. So just simplify it, you will get the answer for Eb, binding energy. Number of protons are 95, then mass of each proton, keep on constant quantity ahe, examination madhe given asil. Okay, so here mass of each proton plus number of neutrons are 149, mass of each neutron minus mass of this nucleus, it's 244 minus 244.06 into c square. Okay, so just simplify it, you will get the value of Eb, and the value of Eb comes up to be, Eb means binding energy, after substituting all the values, okay, substitute the values in terms of U or AMU, atomic mass unit, because 1 U, it is equal to 931.5 mega electron volt per c square. So to c square and c square kya hoil, cancel hoil. Okay, so directly fakta ya value na tumhala kay karaycha ahe, multiply karaycha ahe. Okay, so Eb is equal to, its value is 1.83 into 10 raised to 3. So Eb per unit number of nucleon. So Eb by A, remember this conversion, it is very important. Okay, so Eb by A, it's 1.83 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 244. So your final answer will be 7.5 mega electron volt, means 7.5 into 10 raised to 6 electron volt, and 10 raised to 6 electron volt means mega electron volt. Okay, now next example. Calculate the energy released in the following reaction, given the masses to be, masses given ahe tumhala, carbon, lead, uranium, barium, krypton, aisa grand se masses tumhala dilele ahe, and ignoring neutrino energy, just find the energy released in each process. Okay, so the first process is radium 88 223, its atomic number and the mass number, it gives Pb 82 and mass number is 209. Okay, plus C means carbon 640. Okay, so this is the nuclear reaction, and find energy released in this process. So again use the same formula, energy delta E, or just called binding energy, okay, Eb, it is equal to delta M times C square, and that energy is also represented by symbol Q. सो ईबी लिहिण्याच्याऐवजी तुम्ही क्यू यूज करू शकता, अमाऊंट ऑफ एनर्जी रिलीज्ड इन दिस प्रोसेस. ओके, सो क्यू इज इक्वल टू डेल्टा एम इन टू सी स्क्वेअर. सो क्यू इज इक्वल टू, वी कॅन राईट, मास ऑफ रॅडियम मायनस मास ऑफ पी बी मायनस मास ऑफ सी, ओके, इन टू सी स्क्वेअर. ओके, नाव सबस्टिट्यूट द व्हॅल्यूज, ऑल द व्हॅल्यूज आर गिव्हन. सो फॉर रॅडियम इट्स 223.0185 मायनस, फॉर पी बी इट्स 208.9811 मायनस, फॉर दिस 14.00324 टाइम्स सी स्क्वेअर. ऑल द मासेस आर गिव्हन, ओके, इन द एक्झाम्पल, राईट. सो सगळे मासेस हे यू मध्ये आहेत, अटॉमिक मास युनिट मध्ये आहेत. सो पुन्हा मगाचंच कन्वर्जन आपण यूज करणार आहोत. वन यू इज इक्वल टू 931.5 मेगा इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट डिवाइडेड बाय सी स्क्वेअर. ओके, सो जस्ट हे सॉल्व करा आणि त्याला या व्हॅल्यूनं तुम्ही काय करायचं आहे, मल्टीप्लाय करायचं आहे. सो युअर आन्सर विल बी इन मेगा इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट. सो तिथे सी स्क्वेअरची व्हॅल्यू सबस्टिट्यूट करायची आवश्यकता नाही. सो क्यू इज इक्वल टू, आफ्टर सिम्प्लिफाइंग दिस ब्रॅकेटेड क्वांटिटी, ओके, आफ्टर डुईंग दिस सबट्रॅक्शन विल गेट 0.03416. ओके, आणि त्याला या व्हॅल्यूनं मल्टीप्लाय करून टाका. सो 931.5 मेगा इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट अपॉन सी स्क्वेअर. हा सी स्क्वेअर आणि हा सी स्क्वेअर काय होईल, कॅन्सल होईल. म्हणजे इथे फक्त मला या व्हॅल्यूनं मल्टीप्लाय करायचं आहे. सो राहील फक्त काय, मेगा इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट. ओके, आणि ते तुमचं फायनल आन्सर असेल. क्यू इज इक्वल टू 31.8200 मेगा इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट. ओके, सो द यूज द फॉर्म्युला क्यू इज इक्वल टू डेल्टा एम सी स्क्वेअर. ओके, सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट रिएक्शन. नाऊ द सेकंड वन, सेकंड रिएक्शन इज युरेनियम 92, मास नंबर इज 236, गिव्स बेरियम and krypton. Okay, for barium atomic number is 56, mass number is 140, and for krypton 36 and 90, sorry it's 94 plus 2 neutrons. Okay, so similarly again use the same formula, q is equal to delta m times c square. Okay, so q is equal to delta m means the difference in the masses, discrepancy in the masses of the parent nuclei and the daughter nuclei. So yacha mass ani yacha mass. Okay, so mass of uranium minus mass of barium minus mass of krypton. Okay, minus mass of 2 times mass of neutron. Okay, into c square. बघा प्रत्येकाच्या मासेसचा आपण काय केलेलं आहे, वजा बाकी. ओके, सो मायनस 2 टाइम्स मास ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन बिकॉज 2 न्यूट्रॉन्स आर इमिटेड. ओके, सो जस्ट सबस्टिट्यूट द व्हॅल्यूज, अगेन गिवन व्हॅल्यूज, आणि शेवटी 931.5 काय करा, मल्टीप्लाय करा. ओके, सो या सगळ्यांच्या मासेसची वजा बाकी येईल 0.18358 इंटू 931.5 मेगा इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट. सी स्क्वेअर आणि सी स्क्वेअर कॅन्सल होती. सो युअर फायनल आन्सर इज 171 मेगा इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट. लाईकवाईज यू सॉल्व फॉर द थर्ड रिएक्शन. आय विल जस्ट गिव द रिएक्शन अँड यू सॉल्व बाय युअर ओन. कार्बन 611 इट्स बोरॉन. ओके, 5 मास नंबर 11 प्लस 1 पॉझिट्रॉन ई प्लस प्लस न्यूट्रिनो. ओके, पण त्यांनी एक्झाममध्ये सांगितलेलं आहे, एक्झाम्पलमध्ये सांगितलेलं आहे, प्लीज इग्नोर दिस न्यूट्रिनो एनर्जी. सो तुम्हाला फक्त या तिघांसाठी काढायचं आहे. ओके, सो डेल्टा एम मीन्स मास ऑफ कार्बन मायनस मास ऑफ बोरॉन मायनस मास ऑफ पॉझिट्रॉन. ओके, आणि सॉल्व्ह करायचं. सगळ्यांचे मासेस तुम्हाला गिव्हन आहेत एक्झाम्पलमध्ये. ओके, नाव नेक्स्ट एक्झाम्पल, नेक्स्ट वन Calculate the binding energy of the alpha particle given its mass to be 4.00151. So binding energy aplala calculate karaychi ahe konasathi alpha particle means helium nucleus. Okay, and mass of the alpha particle is given, means m alpha is 4.00151 unified atomic mass unit. So this is the m alpha. So find the mass of proton. So mass of proton is nothing but the 1.0728 U. It's a constant quantity and given in the example. So 1.00728 U. That's a conversion karta na aplala kay karaycha ahe 9. Just use the value of U. Okay, U is equal to 931.5 mega electron volt by C square. So just multiply this number by 931.5 mega electron volt C square. So mass of proton is equal to, ya doghancha multiplication asel, which is equal to 938.281 mega electron volt by C square. Similarly, mass of neutron, it is equal to mass of neutron is 1.00826 in U, unified atomic mass unit. Okay, so that's a conversion mega electron volt upon C square madhe karta ani yana multiply karayche. So mass of neutron, it is equal to 935.567 upon C square mega electron volt upon C square. Okay, so these are the values. Now just use the formula. Again the same, binding energy is equal to delta m into C square. Okay, solve it. So in order to find the binding energy, first find delta m. And ya case madhe magashi apan energy liberate hotana che delta m baghitli, ata mass defect sathi apan pahatoy. So mass defect sathi kay yenar, z times mass of proton plus n times number of neutrons, mass of each neutron minus m. So all the values are there. Helium ahe, alpha particle ahe, so 2He4. Alpha particle means 2He4. So how many protons are there? 2 protons. Mass of each proton is known. How many neutrons are there? 2. Mass of each neutron is known. Okay, so just substitute the values, you will get the answer. Okay, so final answer, binding energy, it is equal to 2 times mass of proton plus 2 times mass of neutron minus mass of helium. Okay, which is given in the example, or mass of alpha particle is given in the example. Okay, and your final answer will be binding energy is equal to 28.289 mega electron volt. So this is your final answer, right? So ya paddhatine mass defect vagere find out kela jata. Jeva binding energy mass defect ni solve karaychi aste, teva mass of the constituent nucleons minus mass of the nucleus. Ani ja velela tumhi energy released in the processes, in the decays or the nuclear reactions, to q kadta tya velela ithe सगळ्यांच्या मासेसची वजाबाकी. ओके, नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल, कॅल्क्युलेट द एनर्जी रिलीज्ड इन न्यूक्लियर रिएक्शन. न्यूक्लियर रिएक्शन इज गिवन लिथियम 3-7 गिव्स 2 अल्फा. गिवन मास ऑफ लिथियम एटम एंड द हेलियम एटम टू बी. ओके, मास ऑफ द लिथियम एटम इज गिवन in terms of U, 7.016 U, and mass of the alpha particle, helium atom means alpha particle, it's 4.0026 U respectively. Find the binding energy in the process. Okay, so here find the energy released in the nuclear reaction. Okay, so in order to find the energy liberated, energy released in the process, Q is equal to delta M C square. Okay, so here to find the delta M, okay, the mass of lithium minus the mass of P plus 2 times the mass of the alpha particle times C square. Okay, so just substitute the values and you will get the answer for Q as, the final answer for Q as 7.272 mega electron volt. Okay, now rest of the examples solve by your own.